We do not need to rush. We should see this desert for ourselves.
Look, I know we can't trust prophecy, but I'm not sure we should just ignore what we saw either.
We are not ignoring it. We will discuss it back home. For now, I wish to search for the wounded animal you heard earlier.
You? Really?
Yes.
Well, okay then. Good. Yeah, lead the way. Hey, Mimir. Between me and Tyr, who'd ever guess I was the giant, huh?
Indeed, lad.
That's a fair few birds you've hunted. I wonder if it might be worth visiting the Raven Tree.
Hail, fellow travelers.
Atreus heard a creature in pain in the desert.
Over a storm like this? Most impressive.
You know Alfheim pretty well, right? Do you have any idea what's out there?
No, sorry. The elves and I... Long story, but it's best when we keep out of each other's way. Hive matter is... stickier than I care for. Good luck on your search, though. Stuff some cloth in your ears to keep the sand out. Don't knock it till you've tried it.
Would have been a shame to have left that behind.
This axe just keeps getting stronger. Want something in particular? Something in mind? Have we more to talk about?
What are these animals?
Gulon, native to Vanaheim. Not sure what they're doing here.
Someone trained them to pull a sled. Lucky for us.
Domesticated Gulon. Most unusual.
Any particular direction to find your wounded animal? Or are we just enjoying the weather?
I can't hear anything out here.
Perhaps we find a cave first to catch our bearings? Behind you, watch out! Behind you, look out!
What's that?
A diagram for a sword hilt.
Perhaps we should show it to one of the dwarves. They'll know what to do.
Huh?
So you just refuse to pick a favorite poem? That's uncharacteristically indecisive of you.
I have a favorite poem already. One from my homeland.
There's a cave entrance!
This cave extends underneath the desert. Is the creature within?
Yeah, sounds like it. We'll find it if we keep going. What is this place?
A refuge for the Dark Elves, by the looks of it. One of the few remaining, now that they're barred from the temple.
Great.
Ugh.
You know, now that I know more about the Dark Elves, I wish we didn't have to fight them.
They attack us.
Well, this is their home. And considering what happened the last time we were in Alfheim, can you really blame them?
Patience. A virtue or a threat?
Depends on the reader. The creature you hired. What does it say now?
It's not always like that. Some animals are just... I feel what they're feeling, you know? And whatever this thing is, it's in a lot of pain.
I see.
Why do you ask?
I am curious.
Really?
I am capable of curiosity.
Okay. Okay.
Hmm.
talk to animals or enchanted rings or whatever.
Much has changed for both of us.
Well, yeah. I'm just trying to figure out why you'd help some random animal.
Is this not what you want?
No, it is. I'm just surprised it's what you want, too. To abandon it. But if we have to kill a bunch of dark elves to get there...
I remember a young lad whom, until this very moment, would take on an army of Draugr to save a wounded animal.
But these aren't undead Draugr. They're elves. I just want to make sure we're not repeating the same mistakes. Getting involved where we shouldn't. Why does it feel like no matter what we do in Alfheim, we wind up hurting Darkhead?
We are down here to help the creature you heard.
I know that, but I'm usually the one who drags us around trying to rescue animals. Why do you care so much? Is there something you're not telling me?
No.
Okay. Is it?
Great Gefjun's ghost! That's the largest bloody half goof I've ever laid eyes on!
It's not just in pain. It's trying to sing.
It's the Song of the Sands. They don't normally sing like this underground.
Is that what's causing the storm?
Aye. Judging by all this hive matter weighing it down, it's been trapped here for dozens of winters.
Don't worry, Lynch. Get you out.
What is that name?
Well, the last squid thingy we saw was Diener, so...
Oh boy. While I appreciate the attempt at humor, that little brother is truly awful wordplay. Embarrassing, really.
Oh, well, can't all be winners.
Ugh!
like it can move now, but it still can't get out.
Much of the hive matter is gone. We can free it from the surface now.
Why did they trap it down here?
Halfgifers are known to burrow, so I hesitate to place full blame on our Dark Elf friends.
But it's trapped in their hive stuff.
Hive matter doesn't belong to the Dark Elves, any more than the light belongs to the Light Elves. It's just another of Alfheim's natural resources, one the Elves have used since the time of their ancestors. And while the Light Elves seem keen to banish the hive over on their side, the Dark Elves make effective use of it out here in the Barrens.
So, by clearing out all of this hive, are you hurting yourself?
You wish to leave the creature enslaved?
No.
Then let us free it.
This is the spot! We can cut the half-goofa loose here!
It flies? Of course it flies! It's a half-goofa!
Sounds much happier now. And hey, the storm's gone!
Aye! Perhaps we'll finally earn some goodwill from our Dark Elf friends after all.
Look, Father, thanks for bringing us out here, but you don't have to do this kind of stuff just to keep my mind off Ragnarok, you know?
This was not a distraction.
No? Then why are we really out here?
Have you ever considered... He just wants to spend time with you, lad, while he still can.
Really?
We do not know what lies ahead. But if Ragnarok approaches, I wish to enjoy the time we have left.
I don't know what to say. Thank you for bringing us out here. I'm glad we did this.
As am I.
Something I'm not sure I quite understand. In the Ragnarok prophecy, Odin knows, all the realms get destroyed, including Asgard. In the version Groa kept secret, Asgard still falls. Wouldn't Odin have tried to prevent it either way? What difference did her lie really make?
Brother, wait. Do you notice that? Atreus, I've been considering your question about whether Groa's deception made a difference. I think of it this way. When it comes to subverting prophecy, knowledge is power. Without the full picture and context, the finer details can lead you to tragically incorrect interpretations.
Let this wait. Stay alert.
Sort of a harp. I can play beautifully, you know.
I do not. And would prefer it remain that way.
brother. You ever think of cooking meat with those blades?
Yes. No. They would foul the meat.
Oh, because of the magic on them?
The blood.
Ah, yes. Carry on then. Now, if I recall, we were discussing how manipulating the details of a prophecy can wreak havoc on the believers. Back in my homeland, I was privy to the operations of a certain coven of heath witches who were keen on destabilizing the government. They picked an influential thane, an otherwise loyal man, and fed him a story of his own ascension to king. They dressed it up in enough details they knew would come to pass, so when they did, the thane took it as confirmation.
Set that aside for now. Come.
Oh, definitely need that.
Whatever you need, I'll create. And Atreus? What about your son? Need something? And in pristine condition, too. Oh, got time.
Returning to my anecdote about the Heath Witches, they fed the Thane a prophecy of his ascension to king. Next thing you know, he's helping matters along. He murders his king, sleeping under his own roof. Murders many he once called friends, too, thinking them fated to oppose him. Then, for a finishing touch, the witches revisit this usurper.
No more for now. Focus.
More bloody draugr.
You're on fire, Kratos. It will pass.
It's bad!
Behind you, brother!
Yeah.
Rogar.
What of her?
Reminds me of tales of a cruel empress. One too angry to die.
We will see.
Come on, brother. Let's have it. You mentioned you had a favorite poem from your homeland. What was it about?
A cunning general. A war over forbidden love.
I believe I've heard of this one. Did it involve a horse that was not as it appeared?
Yes. But that is not what happened.
Oh, it's based on truth then. And you were there.
Yes. I prefer the poem.